Good morning, welcome to prefabricated structures. Today's video is related to joint in structural members. So we know the joints of monolithic construction, such as footing joints to column joints to plinth, and plinth also have a joints between walls with a damp proof course. Then column is having a joints with a lintels, and column is having a joints with the beams, and beams are having a joints with the slabs. Now the question comes, if these all elements are separated, dismantled, or all the elements are casted separately, then how about the joints? So here comes the most biggest question, how will be the joints if most amount of the things are not in proper manner? So the connections, it is the most important thing in the prefabricated structure, such as a minute error of a structure or a minute deviation of a structure will be having a not use in element, means we could not able to use the element if the structure is not so good or the dimensions are not so correct. So let us see some of the connections. So different structural connections in precast buildings. So first one is joining of column to footing. So this all happens whenever the RCC structures are going. The connections are made such that step upon the step, first we will lay the footing, then we will take some part of a starter for the column erection. So there is a joint, but that joint will get hided because both are in the fresh amount of concreting only. Footing is laid after a particular number of days, say of about 7 days, or minimum nowadays at a fourth day on footing, column casting is going to start, because footing and column both are erected with the same steel which is going to come, but wherein prefabricated structures the particular thing will not be same. So let us see in details joining of column to footing, joining of beam to top of column, joining of beam at an intermediate joint, lengthening of column, joining of beams, forming of joints for arched structures, joining of joints of post tensioned structures, joining of precast to monolithic RCC structures. So there are 8 number of joints and 8 number of types of connections. So in this connections, I can say that with this will not be getting completed in only one video. I need to take it for 2 videos or 3 videos. So let us see a single video how much it may permit for us to take the particular part of connections. So let us begin with the first part, joining of column to footing. So joining of column to footing, we have seen that usually it is rigid type connections is most required. Otherwise what happens, the connections are not so clear in this particular part. So we require most easy and connectability such type of connections. So usually it is rigid. It may be also like a hinge like connections. We have seen some of the column and footing hinges design which we have done, the same way hinge like connections can also be done in this part. Methods: a rigid joint can be made by placing a column into legs at the footing, or by using welded joints So we have to see which type of the connections are there, and then we will continue the part. So in this part we will see the method. So this is the first part where column is placed into clacks. So where we can see this part is totally acting as a footing part. This part is acting as a footing. We can see the embedded steel reinforcements also are there. And this is the column where it is allowed to place into the footing clacks. So this opening we are what we calling it as a clacks. So here after it is erected and plumbed vertically, means there should not be any deviation in the erection also. Sometimes in RCC we also get some deviations in the columns. After the casting at the high rise structures, we come to know that the column is erected from one point to another point. That moment it should not happen. For that reason we need to take care also. So here we have to think that how to place this particular. So this is laid earlier into the bed of the footing, on the bed of the footing, then a column is taken. So when the column is taken, what all parts will be provided? Steel plate to ensure proper posting of column. So this is the proper positioning of column is ensured. So this particular notch type, why we are doing it is, so easily it can be erected inside. So this much width is not there. So it is hardly about 6 to 10 centimeters, means maximum 4 inches will be there. But usually they cannot provide more than 4 inches or maximum about 4 inches. Less than 4 inches can be easily provided. So that way there can be opening is provided. Column is placed and then later the concrete filling is taken. In this part we can say the concrete fill is made. So after the concrete gets hardened, then that time we can easily say that the concrete is placed into the footing clacks. Okay, so this is first step. What are the advantages? It is simpler, requires less time, suitable for small column, that is placing, pumping, fixing of the column and filling clacks with concrete is easier. Then this method is the least resistive to inaccuracies arises during the construction. So we can say there are less amount of most problems. So least resistive to inaccuracies. So this is the first type. Then there is one more type wherein the welding can be used. Steel plate is used, then welding is provided in the column footing. Same this concrete is provided. So this steel plate is made available to add the footing itself only. Then the welding connections are taken at the edges also. Some steel plate is provided here into the joints. So here the steel reinforcements, whatever there, that will be the having connections. So here the welding will take. So what are the disadvantages? Moment arising from fixity of column demands double bearing. So whatever the rotation will be taking place, that will be having a demand of double bearing, support of double things. So that's why they are providing one here and as well as one here. The access material to bear this moment is insignificant for small columns. So maximum moment which will be coming here, because it is not monolithically, means they are not constructed at once, there will be having a moment. We need to understand that we are just inserting one element into the other element. So whereas some load is acting on the standing element, then there will be a rotational effect at the bottom or the support wherever the second element is joined. That moment it will be having some of the disadvantages. Then comes joining of column to beam on the top of column. So how this particular beam will be joined at the top of the column? By overlapping the steel bars or by hooked steel bars. So here we can see the steel bars whichever are coming from the column will be overlapped in the beam. Then it will be taken connections, or we will take a particular reinforcement of a hook steel bar. Hook steel bar is provided into the beam bottom where it will be connected such as a hook, so that it should not deviate from its position. That's why it is hooked in the beam base, then it is connected. Then joining of a column to beam on a top of column. One more is a welding type of joining and a welding of column to the footprint. This is the second part which will the welding is taken similarly. So advantages: it is effective and widespread method, it is easily accessible, it ensures the well executed work and adequate control over the work. It is more economical for larger member than the clacks method. So wherever the weldings are done, we can have some firm joints. The rigid joints will be available whenever the weldings are conducted. So again, by overlapping steel bars, when we have seen the overlapping of steel bars, how it will be coming, this is the particular A column. So here the A column will be there. Then this is the B beam and this is the B beam where it is going to come. So up to this element part, it will be totally beam is coming. Up to this element part, there will be column will be coming. So this level will be maintained at the beam base. This top of the column level will be maintained at the beam base. Then beam is having one of the ejected element and a column is also having a small ejected element. They both are resting over. Then that particular part will be concreted. So this remaining opening part is going to get casted in the concrete and it will become as a in situ concrete. So the joint will be firmly, but it will not take much load as it is taken in the monolithic part because the reinforcements may be sometimes. So we see that the reinforcements are to be embedded into the particular parts. So producing from both the members. Then comes by welding. So if a reinforcements are allowed, so see here this particular column top and beam bottom are at meeting at same level and reinforcement is taken. So this reinforcement and this side reinforcement both will, it will be coming and welding is made. Then the welding after completion, concreting is made at the particular concrete joint. So the concrete whichever is placed at this concrete will be having minimum amount of connections at this particular joint and the welding of connection beam is rested over the column directly and with a steel plate it is welded at the bottom. Simple method for rigid junctioning fitting column with a beam at a girder. At the top of a column, the use of overlapping steel with beam and subsequently concrete is alone. So limitations, demands more care and skill, increased use of steel, execution of work is complicated because the work must be performed at a greatest on the light scaffold suspended on the beam itself. So we have to see some of the limitations are there, such as demand more care and skill is required. Then use of steel is more, as we take the steel, it is be more used in this particular. So we have to understand that part also in this particular type of connections. So this is hinge like joining of column to girders. So we can see there is a hinge point. Hinge point there where will be moments are zero. So they are just simply supported, but they will allow the rotation of the beam. So this is the column, beam, girders, steel plate. So this steel plate will act as a hinge. So we can also see in insulation plating such as the beam as well as the resting here. Then on a column, a mortar bed with a single rod, it is resting, means it is having a single rod connections wherein the moments are more clear in the beam or girder connections. So then comes a column. So bifurcated column such as one and the other end, it is continued. Column is taken. So here we can see the column beam is opening provided the width of the beam will be also increasing. Beam 1 and beam 2, two beams are there. They are connected to one column. And if a particular beam is taken further, that time the beam connections are made in this particular opening and beam connections are taken into the lengthening of the beam part. It is easiest method, that is placing a beam on the top of the column. At the resting place, both the top of the column and underside of the beam must be furnished, means clear finish should be there, and steel placed anchor into the concrete, means it should be finished as well as steel placed plates are to be mandatory in the concrete so that the stool to steel two steel plates rest on each other and they may have a firm joint connections if we are doing the welding connections at these particular two welding steel plate joints. Thank you. See you in the next video of joints in structural members.